Hey everyone, I'm John Redmond of Horizon Hobby, and today I've got my great friend David Payne, senior product developer in the air category, in with us. David, how are you doing?
Great.
So we brought in the brand new little ultra micro GB, and I know it's near and dear to your heart. Why don't you tell us a little bit about it?
You know, I mean, we looked at it and we came out with AS3X and we were thinking about the technology and what it could do. And you know, we kind of wanted to bring to light something that traditionally in the past has not been so, I won't say unsuccessful, but kind of tough to do in the modeling world.
Very.
Let's say that.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of people who've tried to do model GBs over the years, and I myself haven't seen a lot of success rate, I guess you would say. They're just, you know, they fly great in the air, but they have some challenges to them. They really do.
Challenges of getting off the ground, getting back on the ground, especially if the outline's not cheated at all.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So, as you said earlier, AS3X allows us to do this and makes it fly incredibly well?
Yes, absolutely. The airplane is very close to scale. You know, we haven't stretched the airplane. We haven't made it look disproportional. It's still very much the Gee Bee R2.
Right.
But with AS3X, you know, the airplane, I've flown a lot of GBs, and most all of them fly pretty well in the air. This one flies like a pattern plane in the air.
I mean,
it's you just draw a line, and it follows it. It doesn't care if it's on its side, its back. It just doesn't matter. It's going to go where you point it. And then, you know, takeoffs and landings, that's always been a huge challenge with this type of airframe. Any type of airframe like this with a high center of gravity, really close together landing gear, really narrow landing gear, it's always been a challenge, of course.
And being a little short and stubby.
And very short and stubby, too, to add to that, with a lot of power in the front of it. So, you know, we did a lot to try to improve just the airframe itself before even the AS3X came into to play with it. We wanted to make sure it was still as best as it could be, just in general. So, you know, we did a lot to the landing gear and a lot of different things to try to make it as capable as it could be, just straight out of the box. And then add AS3X in with it, and it really makes it very successful to pretty much anybody, you know, intermediate to advanced consumer can just take the airplane and go have a good time with it.
Okay, so we're going to get back later on about taking off and landing,
sure.
And you're going to give us some tips and tricks on how to do that. But first, I mean, I'm taking a look. We have got some incredible detail. I'm seeing kind of fabric rib looks back here, and then, of course, the ribbed wing, little vents, panel lines. Talk to us about the airplane. What went into it, power system? What's going on here?
You know, I did a lot of research on this airplane, and I was actually fortunate enough. The guys at Fantasy of Flight down in Florida, you know, they have, Kermit Weeks has this airplane. He got it from Del Mar. And they were nice enough to let me come down there and just climb all over that airplane and look at it and get some pictures with it. So, you know, we did a lot of research. We did a lot of, you know, kind of theory into this airplane. And it is very close to exactly what you'd see on the real one. You know, we went the extra mile. You know, we've got the simulated radial motor. We've got the pilot in there. You know, we've got a lot of things that kind of just add the features of the GB and kind of give it that feel and look.
Okay. Now, cool things I've seen. We've got a little plastic fin cap.
Yeah.
And we have little plastic caps on the landing gear here.
And on the,
on the chin, because inevitably,
it is a GB.
It's a GB.
Yes,
you can't take that
absolutely
away from it.
It's still a very short coupled airplane. And, you know, if you get it a little sideways or in a crosswind, it could roll over.
Okay.
Luckily enough, it's very lightweight.
Right.
You know, so it's still in the tradition of the ultra micros where they just, you know, they're pretty hard to hurt, to be honest with you. If you've got the power off, they're just going to kind of maybe tumble a little and keep going. But we wanted to make sure you weren't going to get all the foam dinged up and start looking kind of bad if you did that a couple times. So I went ahead and did some little plastic pieces here and there that are the key points of where you're going to hit if you do roll over.
So then it was interesting at iHobby. I had one guy look at me. He says, "How do you get the battery in?" And you've hit it incredibly well. I mean, I was amazed. It just rolls up. Monster opening up there. You'd almost think you could put a huge battery.
Yeah.
What's it come with?
It comes with a 2S200. It's the same battery as we have in like the Ultra Micro Striker.
Okay.
Exact same battery. And it works very well with that battery. You get a good flight time out of it. We've got the 3000 kV motor in there, which is the exact same as the Micro Striker.
Mm-hmm.
But the prop is different from the Micro Striker. It's a little different prop tuned for this airframe. So, you know, that's your power system. You get good flight time and quite good speed. I mean, it's got that racer feel.
Oh, it does. I would agree.
Yeah.
I would agree. So,
and then of course you have AS3X with technology in there too. So, and plenty of room, you know, like you said, to get to your battery and anything you need to do there.
Okay. Now, replacing parts on the airplane. Is it feasible to replace wings, tails, or is it one of those that maybe not due to certain features of it? What do you think?
You know, it just all depends on I guess the time and effort you want to put into it. You
right.
know, the GB is it's pretty much a one piece airframe. We didn't have the luxuries that you have on some of the ultra micros where it's kind of it's basic four general pieces, you know, vertical, horizontal, wing,
right.
and fuselage. The GB, especially with the landing gear and the flying wire system, you had to have it pretty much all together as one unit. So to replace things, it may be a little more complicated. You know, if you need to replace a landing gear or something like that, it'd probably be pretty good. If you went into trying to replace a stab or a wing, it may be better to get new pieces.
Just get a new airplane.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So now let's talk about being out at the field.
Sure.
Got the battery in it. We're sitting out there. We're on the runway. Using your transmitter, what is the preferred takeoff method for the GB? We've got AS3X in there doing what it does mm-hmm. and such helping. What is David Payne's tricks? Because I've watched you, and I'm telling you, you can take this thing straighter, let's take it off straighter, than you can half your jets.
Sure.
It's amazing. How do you do that?
You know, let's back up just a little bit.
Okay.
AS3X, literally, it's chart, I mean, bind and fly. I mean, I don't
right.
have anything special in here. There's no mixing. There's
okay.
no, you know, dual rates are 170% just in case you're flying like off a 5E or something like
right,
that.
Right, right.
Standard setup. No expo, no
nothing. Massive expo, nothing. Okay.
Sure. You know, for takeoffs, to be honest with you, the GB, especially now that it has AS3X and the things we've done to it, literally takeoffs, you know, the big key is into the wind, of course. It's,
right.
it's still very short coupled. So if you're not into the wind, it's pretty much going to turn itself into the wind.
Well,
it's
I can understand
that airplane.
That. I can understand that.
But if you line up into the wind or no wind at all, literally with this airplane, a little bit of back pressure, slowly advance the throttle, and it's going to drive itself. I mean, it's like an arrow. Takeoffs are so uneventful for this airplane. It's kind of eerie. You know, they're smooth as glass, and there's not a lot of steering required. There's not a lot of chasing it. You know, it's
right.
with AS3X in it, it's just really just kind of a smooth, gradual thing, and it'll take itself off.
Okay. We're in the air. We're flying.
Sure.
We're having a great time.
Yep.
Hey, we're hitting 3.5 minutes. We probably want to come in and put another battery in because we're having a great time. So, landing. Is there a special setup in the downwind, or can you just roll in and start it to happen? What do you want to do?
There's multiple ways you can do it. The best way I've found that, you know, if you don't have a lot of familiarity with narrow-geared airplanes mm-hmm. and short-coupled airplanes, and I've explained this to people, and repeatedly it works every single time. So I feel pretty good about the success rate of it. You know, it does have a lot of frontal drag and stuff. So you want
right.
to carry a little power to the ground.
Okay.
You don't want to just cut the power and dive at the ground. If you do that, you've got kind of a one-chance flare, just like you would with any type of airplane. The best way I've found is, of course, you line up into the wind. And in your final approach, you carry just a little bit of power. I mean, just a little bit. Just barely above off the bottom of your stick. You know, you're
okay.
just barely carrying an idle. And as you fly in, you get, you know, just a standard descent, just like normal. When you get about 6 inches off of the ground, It's just a normal motion. You just pull off the throttle and you pull up on the stick.
And
it'll flare out and round out and it'll just touch down just as gentle as you can be.
So now these guys can do the landing they've seen in the product video.
Exactly. It's you know, that was the big thing that I guess was really on my mind is somebody explained it to me the other day. It was funny, we were talking about the GBs and he was like, every GB I've ever seen fly, it's one of those things where you get all nervous and you manage to get it off the ground. And then you're flying and you're flying and flying, but you can't enjoy the flight because the whole time you're thinking, oh my God, I got to get it back on the ground.
Right, exactly.
You know?
Exactly.
This one here, you can enjoy the flight because landings, I mean, really, it's, you know, as long as you're in the wind, you round out, be real gentle, it'll 3-point just as settled as pretty as it can be. It won't give you any trouble at all. You can, you know, you can do touch and goes. There's that stuff in the video. There's all kind of different ways you can land it, but that has been routinely the success rate landing if you, you know,
from just about
just
anybody.
A simple standard, just come in with a little bit of power, gently at about 6 inches, just pull off the power and pull up at the okay. same time.
Quick question in landing, 2-point wheel landings, do you recommend those? Are they really tough?
If no wind at all, and it's doable. I will tell you there's a trick to wheel landing any airplane, in my opinion. You know, a lot of people, they touch down on the mains, and as soon as they touch down on the mains, they think they're done, so they pull back on the stick. And that is where it goes wrong.
Right.
You still have airspeed, quite a bit more airspeed than what you think you do.
Right.
So as you touch down on the mains, the trick is to release some of the back pressure on the elevator and put more pressure on the mains and let it slow down and settle the tail.
Yeah, I agree. I agree.
And you can do that, but it takes a little more, you know, practice, I guess.
So we're going to try the success system and pull them both of those
I think
back.
The 3-point is the big success. Another key feature I'd like to hit on, you know, we've seen some of the threads right now, and a lot of people are questioning, well, you know, it can't take off a grass. You're right. It's not meant to take off a grass. And,
exactly.
And I know a lot of guys out there, they just pull their gear off their Ultra Micros to go fly on the grass. I promise you, with all this structure on here.
Yeah, no.
You can't pull the gear off, but you can fly it in grass. Don't feel like you can't. You know, hand launch it, go fly, have fun. When you get ready to land, just pull the power all the way off and stall it out, and it'll just plop right into the grass. You're not going to hurt the airplane. You're not going to tear anything up. You'll still be able to enjoy your airplane just like anybody else.
Very good. Well, there you have it, guys. David Payne, designer, developer of the Gee Bee R2. Pretty incredible airplane, and let's face it, this could be the first mass success story of the Gee Bee in the history of the airplane.
We've really enjoyed it, and I hope everybody does too. It's a lot of fun.
Well, I really appreciate you
no
stopping
problem.
By.
Thanks for having me.
Talking to us. Guys, you saw it right here at Horizon Hobby, the Gee Bee R2. Great little ultra micro. You definitely want to get one of these. Remember, if you have any questions or comments, you can always find me at editors@horizonrc.com. We'll see you at the flying field.